Morning.
Moron, good moron, cousin. And there she goes. Wednesday morning in Bavaria. Wednesday morning in Bavaria. Clocking are half neo. It's 8:30 in the morning. And Helen went to get, Helen's my cousin. She went into town just to get some fresh bread and buns. And there's bicycle paths all over the place here. And it's a very, very intelligent, sensible way to deal with transportation. Good morning again, cousin.
Good morning.
Broad?
Yes. This is new bread.
Broad?
Well, yeah, they need
bread.
So we must have
testa. Yeah. That are good. This is the old train station, the Gamla Togstad in Valberga. And they've changed the train tracks into a bicycle walking path.
One of the things that impressed me, in fact, the thing that impressed me the most was the bike pass. I had a cousin named Leif, rode 30 kilometers a day to work in a seatbelt factory for Volvos. And there was a lot of that around. In Stockholm, everybody's riding bicycles. And there was wind power everywhere. And people belonged to cooperatives. They owned shares in these electric generating windmills. And North America could learn a great deal from how Sweden has decided to go in that direction. Grandpa Peterson came from Laholm, Alstorp, near Laholm, which is about, I would say, 80 miles northeast of Malmo. And as you can see, it's good farm country, and it's near Easby, which is where the Carlson family came from, Hans Carlson, and that's how he met Grandpa's sister Botilda, and they ended up in Minnesota. Well, around 1900, it became apparent to Grandpa that staying in Sweden wasn't necessarily a good idea. So he and his brothers, Edvin, Ben, Alf, and Gottfried, moved out to the States, stayed with Botilda, and made their way to different parts of the country. 50 years later, it was almost time for my grandparents' 50th wedding anniversary, but unfortunately, Nana Peterson died on August 16, 1958. When I was a kid, I used to sleep with Grandpa on weekends when we'd stay over, and I'd see this painting on the wall. He'd be snoring, and the light would be shining in from the street on Yale Road, and I'd see this painting, and I always wanted to see that house. And it wasn't until a couple of years ago, when my Swedish relatives came to visit with pictures, that I found out the house was still there. Well, this is what it looked like when the painting was made 50, 60 years ago, and this is what it looked like 3 weeks ago. So it was really, really an emotional experience for me to finally get to that spot. My grandfather's brother, Carl, his granddaughter, Camilla, lives in this house now, and next door is Dagny. She's the widow of Helen's brother, Bertil. So the house is still in the family, which is great, the farm. And you'll see a lot of these types of Swedish flags flying outside of homes in Sweden. Symbol of pride. We should do more of that here, I think. But aside from the addition of a sunroom and some much-needed renovations, this house looks pretty much the way it did 120 years ago. And it was really good for me to be there and be able to, you know, walk around. And one thing that was really special for me was Helen told me about when my mom came in 1959. The two of them walked down this path towards those woods back there because they were following my grandpa and his brother Carl, who were discussing things very loudly. And Helen and my mom, one not speaking much English, one not speaking much Swedish, communicated as best they could as they walked back to where these trees and these rocks were. So for me, it was really a special experience to be able to do that again. Anyway, the farm is in good shape, and when my grandparents came over in 1947 on the Frederick VIII, there was a picture taken of Nana with Helen next to one end of the house, so I thought it'd be kind of nice to stand in the same spot and do the same thing with Helen 63 years later, so I did. Anyway, it was just really, really special for me to be there and show you what it looks like. This was Grandpa's brother's August's place in 1966, and before that, the way it looks now. Back in 1959, when my mom was there, they all got together. Very special trip for my mom being there, you know, and visiting all the cousins, Hasse and Hans Ole and Ingrid, and well, Hans Ole, he's still with us. There he is. He's over at Ingrid's farm. Ingrid and Hasse own the farm, and they showed us a great time. A lot of nice artwork, beautiful home. And then they took us to a museum where I saw this wool-covered rubber ball my grandpa used to make for everybody back in the 1950s. I thought I was going to start crying. It was covered with bird shit, but it meant a lot to me, as did seeing these great people and being in this place again. There's Hasse and Ingrid. And so for me to be able to walk the same path as my mother walked with Helen all those many years ago, well, I can't describe how special that made me feel and how glad I was to be there.